Hello, people of the internet, my name is Johnny, and welcome back to some more LEGO FNAF. I have high hopes for this video. We're going into night 6. Hopefully we can beat it, and I'd also like to try and beat night 7 in this video. I think we've got a good strat down. I've learned some of the mechanics of some of the characters, Freddy, Foxy mainly. So night 6, I'll talk a bit about the strategy, but first, Let me get a feel for the game. It's been a little bit since I hopped into it. But basically, the strategy is once Freddy's in the hallway, his immediate next stage of attack is in your office and killing you. So once he gets to that hallway, you basically just want to seal off this door for the rest of the night completely and only focus on Bonnie and also Foxy. Foxy specifically because you need to look at his camera specifically. In FNAF 1, to keep Foxy from progressing, all you need to do is look at the cameras. That has changed. In this game, you have to look at Foxy. I don't know if looking at Freddy still slows him down. Okay. That was close. Hey, Bonnie. So yeah, I'm gonna look at Freddy. I'm gonna look at Foxy a lot as well. There might not be a whole lot of commentary in this video. There might be a lot of jump cuts. Just because I really gotta concentrate. I gotta focus up. And there he goes. He's on the move. Let's keep looking at these two. Hello. Awesome. Something I don't like is, well, for one, when there's no sound effect for you. And two, okay, so Freddy is moving a hell of a lot. Bonnie, I would really love you. I want you to move, man. You gotta get out of here. Okay. Awesome. So Freddy's in the kitchen right now. His next step will be in the hallway. Something I was gonna say is the lights work just a tiny bit different than they do in FNAF 1, where if you have one light on, usually in FNAF 1, like right there, it would just turn on the light I just pressed. But you gotta turn them off in this game, which I'm not really a fan of. But it's kind of like, you know, whatever, gotta deal with it. Foxy also works a bit different. Instead of draining 5% progressively every time he hits the door, he takes 10 all the time. So if Freddy is in the hallway, his next step will be in my office. So now we keep that shut. I don't know. I don't know how long we need to have it shut. Luckily though, when Foxy leaves, this plushie is gonna jump up and down. And after the 6th jump, Foxy gets into the office. Okay. Awesome. Thank you, Bonnie. Going away super quick. We're doing good on power. Doing good with Foxy. Doesn't matter about Chica. Like I said, Chica, Freddy, we don't even think about them. And apparently, while we're just kind of chilling out watching Bonnie and Foxy, there is a Candy the Cat Easter egg, I've been told, where a figure appears on the desk of Candy. And maybe I need to switch up the strat to look for Bonnie on the camera. But really, as long as I'm checking it every now and then, I don't think it matters a whole lot. Though, since we're in endgame, and Foxy's only one phase away from leaving, and we have such low power, you really don't want him to escape. Because if he bangs on my door right now, I instantly go down to like 3%. We might run out of power, but I think we should be able to live in the endgame. Now I think I'm fine to just chill here, because Foxy's not gonna have time. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So hopefully now, should be good. I don't know how long Freddy's music box goes. I'm hoping we're good. I think we- Yes! Yes! Okay! Ooh, that's good! First attempt! Night 6! Oh. That's awesome. That's awesome. Oh, there's my overtime paycheck. $1.20, 50 cents. First attempt, too. That's awesome. Hey, that gives us more time for 420 mode. Oh, I'm not looking forward to that. Let's have a look at custom night. Oh, goody. What the hell is this? Challenges as well. So I think I'm just gonna save those challenges. If you guys want a fourth video on this game, hit the like button. If we get enough, I'll do all these challenges in a separate video. But for now, I'm just gonna do 420, 20, 20, 20, 20 mode, and we'll see how we do. I hope we can beat it in this video, but I might need to concentrate a whole lot, so we'll see how things go. Attempt one right here. Leave in the comments down below your theories. How many attempts will it take? Four, five. So I was trying to count Foxy's thing, and I got it. So it's five jumps where you don't need to check on him. Keeping track of Freddy means nothing. He just goes so goddamn quick. This dead ass might be the whole... this might be the whole night. Just flip, light, check, light, check Foxy, light, Foxy, light. Foxy light. Oh boy. It's a good strat. It's very tedious. This is a similar strat to classic FNAF ones. 20-20-20. Ooh, didn't mean to do that. This one is just slightly different, since it kind of uses Help Wanted's strat. For night five, which, again, was very repetitive. That is the case for most FNAF games, especially the all max modes. Freddy laughing every time you flip up the cams is annoying as hell. This is not good. Power-wise and also Foxy-wise, you know. I gotta really keep an eye on him. Hey, Chucky. It still made me jump a bit. I don't know if you guys saw that on cam. Did make me jump again. Frickin' Charles. Always popping in, scaring the hell out of me. For no reason. Thank you, Chucky. Appreciate that, brother. Not even 5 a.m. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Is he out? No. Oh, he is. God damn it. Two. Three. Four. Yeah. Ah, damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. Freddy, be slow for me, buddy. Yeah, we can sing together all night long, or not. That's fine too. Please, for the fans, one time for the one time. Okay, thank you, Freddy. Yeah, that's the run under. Yeah, you just can't let him knock on the door. God damn it. Oh, I bet I was seconds. So each night is 7 minutes on the dot. I'm timing it right now on my phone. I don't need to buy the stupid item in the item shop. Each hour is exactly 1 minute, 10 seconds. So if I can just optimize my strat to take that into account, it should be good. No shot. I need another 40 seconds. 13, 12, 11. No shot. Oh my god. Dude, are you kidding? I'm just gonna do some simple commentary over the footage of my winning run. This is a pretty self-explanatory strategy for 420. Right now, at the very beginning of the night, I quickly switch between Foxy's cam and Freddy on stage to stall them in place for a bit, especially Freddy at the beginning of the night. And I'm also quickly checking our Bonnie and Chica around my office. If they are, I stop that strategy immediately. But once Chica or Bonnie gets to the office, you stop that strategy of stalling Freddy and Foxy. You let Freddy do his pathing, eventually he'll get to the hallway, and then you close the door. And then you move on to literally the entire strategy for the rest of the entire night. Flipping the camera up and down every now and then to check on Foxy. Usually I like to have him in either his first stage where he's not, you know, peeking out at all, or the second one where he's peeking out of Pirate's Cove just a little bit. It's not the end of the world if he's at his final stage before he rushes down the hallway. I just like to have a little bit of leeway, you know, a little bit of breathing room before he does rush down towards the end of the night. And that's basically the strategy. You've already taken care of Freddy and Chica with the closed door on the right, and just check the light every now and then to see if Bonnie's shown up. If he's there, close the door. Usually after one, two flips of the camera, he'll be gone. It's a very simple strategy. It's pretty easy once you get the hang of it. And then towards the end of the night, just to give myself a little bit more breathing room before I completely lose power, I just stop checking the camera on Foxy. I stop flashing the light for Bonnie. I let Foxy run. Hopefully he doesn't get to my office before I lose power, but if he does get there and bangs on the door, I don't lose a whole lot of time, since I'm about to lose power anyway, and that's basically the entire strategy. It's mostly get lucky with Foxy's progression, and also hopefully Bonnie doesn't show up too often. And then of course get lucky that Freddy is nice to you when you lose power and doesn't completely end your run in about, you know, like 20 seconds. So that's it, that's my strategy that I used for 420 mode on LEGO FNAF, and now let's see me celebrate beating this just hilarious game. Wait. 20 seconds. I don't think so. Less. Wait. Yeah! I did it! Yes! Yes! Oh, thank Christ! I am not doing that 19 more times. What a dumb, stupid achievement to set in your stupid game! I'm just kidding, I really like this game, but oh my god! To be fair, that I'm looking at my recording that only took an hour in total of recording, so that includes night 6, so definitely not too bad. It does get repetitive, which is why I'm so thankful it's over. So yep, I think that's gonna do it for LEGO FNAF for now. Feels good to beat, I'll say that. Feels really good knowing that I've fully beaten the game. Of course, besides the ultimate custom night challenge, or not ultimate custom night, just regular custom night challenges, which I don't know if you get anything for beating them. If you do, and if you guys want to see another video on this game, let me know. I'll come back, I'll do all of them. They don't seem that bad, actually. Like, I mean, Chica's on 20, Chica's fine. It's really just Freddy and Foxy that I had a pretty tough time dealing with. But that's LEGO FNAF. Thank you so much for watching this video. Again, if you want to see me do another video coming back doing those challenges, let me know. But for now, that's going to do it for this episode of LEGO FNAF. And I'll see you all on the flip side.